हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम विवेक जामवाल, टीम मेंबर लेक्सिस एंड कंपनी, एंड माय टुडेज टॉपिक इज ऑनर किलिंग इन इंडिया। सो लेट्स बिगिन आवर टुडेज टॉपिक। ऑनर किलिंग और शेम किलिंग इज द एक्ट ऑफ विनिजेंस, यूजुअली मर्डर ऑफ एनी फैमिली मेंबर और एनी अदर पर्सन हु इज रिलेटेड टू द फैमिली इन विच ही शी इज हेल्ड टू हैव ब्रॉट डिसऑनर और डिसग्रेस टू द फैमिली। दिस इज एक्ट डन बाय द ओन फैमिली मेंबर्स इन ऑर्डर टू रिस्टोर देयर प्राइड एंड ऑनर। In India, there are more than 1,000 cases reported every year, though the figures remain unreliable. Honor killing is basically practiced in northern part and rural areas of India. In many cases, multiple family members plan the murder through a formal family council, and in certain cases where the victim is an outsider, not punishing the latter word, would accuse the family of cowardice. Then Khap Panchayat is a group of organization of caste group court in a village. They support honor killing and specially indulge in offensive act against the couple who want to marry according to their free will. These caste-based councils are common in the inner regions of several Indian states such as Haryana, Rajasthan, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, UP, Uttar Pradesh and parts of Rajasthan. The Khap Panchayat is declared illegal as well as unconstitutional by the court, but still they exist as they believed as they are believed to give up instant verdict to give instant verdict, thereby saving time. But do we actually need it? Reasons for honor killing. There are many reasons for honor killing. First most important reason is when a woman refuses to enter into an arranged marriage. So when a woman refuses to enter into an arranged marriage and wanted to do a love marriage, then this kind of honor killing will take place, and some family members kill that girl. And second reason is marrying outside one's caste or religion. Due to the girl's marriage outside or boy marriages outside their caste or religion, take place of honor killing. Third is when a woman wants to seek a divorce even from an abusive husband. When some woman needs divorce from abusive husband, then husband tries to kill his wife. Fourth, same gotra marriages. Sometimes same gotra marriages leads to honor killing. Then infidelity. Then sixth is allegedly committing adultery. Then when a woman is victim of sexual assault or members, then homosexuality. Then provisions in Indian law. What are the provisions in Indian law to restrict or to ban this honor killing in India? Section 107 to section 116, or section 299 to section 304, and section 307 to 308 of IPC penalizes people for committing or abetting culpable homicide and murder. They also impose punishments for the same. Section 34 and 35 punishes for the an act done by several persons in furtherance of common intention. Section 120A and 120B penalizes whoever is contributed in criminal conspiracy, not only the person who killed the person or who engages in the activity. If a person is helping them, if a person who is anything contributed in this murder or any killing, then he will also be punished by under 120A and 120B. Then honor killing infringes the rights of a person given in Article 14 of Equality Before Law. Article 15, restrictions of discriminations on a ground of religion, caste, gender, age, sex, place of birth, etc. Article 19, protection of freedom of speech and expression. Then Article 21, protection of life and personal liberty. And 39F, protection of children against exploitation and against moral and marital amendment of Indian constitution. Then what are the punishments under Indian law? Then death penalty or lifetime imprisonment and penalty of about 5 lakh to the accused convicted of honor killing. Then in case of grievous hurt, a sentence of 10 years to life imprisonment may be imposed along with the fine of 3 lakh rupees. Then 3 to 5 years of imprisonment with fine up to rupees 2 lakhs will be imposed in case of hurt and injuries. I would like to conclude by saying few lines that summing up, honor killing is a sign of weakness and there is nothing honorable in it. In my view, point is a barbarous and a shameful act prevalent in our society. It is a high time to educate the society about the irrelevance of this crime. However, there are some limitations imposed by courts, but analyzing it from the perspective of our society, it is the orthodox belief which is provoking the family members in doing such a heinous crime. So hope you get to learn from my videos. Thank you.